cowboys in this place? Come on! Yeah. Guess what we were created to do? To make your pain go away. So why don't you just tell the Lord tonight? To make your pain go away.
Cash and gives and money.
Not if today he will.
remember this song.
Say it again, say it again.
Lord, we glorify you, and we lift you up.
Serving you, Lord.
Serving you, Lord, is a privilege. I'm going
to lift you up. Say it again.
Lord, we glorify you,
and we lift you up.
And we lift you up.
Serving you, Lord.
Serving you, Lord, is a privilege. I'm going
to lift
you up.
Oh, 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 oh. And we lift you up. Serving you, Lord.
Serving you, Lord, is a privilege. I'm going to lift you up.
Listen, from the rising of the sun, thank you, Jesus, until the sun is long gone. Thank you, Lord, Lord, you're worthy of praise.
You hear a song in the meeting, but you don't start that. You're hearing it, the gospel.
And we lift you up. Serving you, Lord. Say it again, say it again, say it again, say it again. Serving you, Lord.
Serving you, Lord. Lord, I'm mighty.
Power.
Jesus, I'm gonna lift you up.
Say it again, say it again.
Lord, I'm mighty.
Say it again.
Somebody
better do it now.
Dance, 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 dance.
You're putting the devil up under your feet. Everybody do it. Say it.
Y'all, I'm sorry.
Praise God.
Oh, you came in right on time.
Yes, Lord.
I might be in a daze, but you can't have my praise. No matter the attack, I won't turn back. This means war. This means
war.
This means
war.
This means
war.
This means
war. This means war.
You can't have my family. You can't have my increase. You can't have my breakthrough. You can't have my, you can't have my, you can't have bleed. There's power in the blood. It's a proud protection. It's a proud provision. This means there's power in your praise. That changes things. You can't take this lion down.
This means somebody needs that today. Let me rewind that one more time. Yes.
God is in control.
Okay.
And I say to know my trail, but I'm singing all is well. He's attacking every day, but I'm watching while I pray. No matter the
attack,
I won't turn back. This means war. This means
war.
This means
this means war.
This means
this means
war.
I
bleed the blood. There's power in the blood.
I bleed the blood.
Healing in the blood.
I bleed the blood.
Power in the blood.
I bleed the blood.
Been in the storm and the rain, but the blood still stays the same. Whatever's going wrong, my war clothes are on. I might be in a daze, but you can't have my praise. No matter the attack, I won't turn back. This means war.
This means
war. This means
war.
This means
this means war.
You can't have my family. You can't have my increase. You can't have my breakthrough. You can't have my, you can't have my, you can't, you can't have bleed. It's a prayer protection. It's a prayer provision. This means there's power in your praise. That changes things. You can't take this lion down.
Y'all ready for war? God bless
Praise
you. Thank you for
Lord.
Letting us start a little later this morning.
Good morning, saints. Good morning, good morning. So good to see all your faces. Good to see all the phone numbers. God is so worthy of our praise. Another week, another Sunday. I am just so excited to be in the house of the Lord. We're about to start our praise and worship, although it felt like we already had it, but that's all right. You cannot praise God enough this morning for all his many blessings, for, as I said, keeping us all during the week as we go to and fro and bringing us back home safely. God is so worthy of it. If you are unmuted, please mute yourself right now. We're about to start our praise and worship service. Again, when you're unmuted, it sort of interferes with the sound. So I'm asking if you can mute yourself this morning. We're about to start our praise and worship service. God bless you. Sit back and enjoy.
But as I go from day to day, I can hear my Savior say, trust me, child, come on, I hold your hand.
On the rough side of the mountain.
We are coming up the rough side of the mountain, but that's all right. We got God that's going to help us to the end. We thank God for his promises to never leave us or forsake us. And we can always count on God keeping his word. God bless you. Right now, we're going to go into our announcements. We thank everyone for, again, being here this morning. And another virtual service at Mount Moriah Community Church. We thank you for the fellowship and for your presence. And every Sunday, until God should say the same, we will be here virtually every Sunday at 11:30, receiving a word from the Lord through our pastor, John Sheckett. Again, invite a friend. Invite a friend to our services. And don't forget our 11:15. We kind of have another service at 11:15, join us then. You're more than welcome to join us early at 11:15, but our service starts at 11:30. God bless. If you have every first Sunday, I almost forgot to say that, every first Sunday, please join us for communion. Prepare a little juice, a little cracker, whatever, to fellowship, commune every first Sunday during communion. We thank you for that. Right now, we're going to introduce our prayer requests. I don't know, toward the end of our service, we have a list of names on our prayer list. Please put your name, if you have someone you want to be on the prayer list, put it on in the chat, or you can email us. Email us a list of prayers, a list of names, to Mount Moriah Community Church email address, which is mtmcc7@aol.com. Another portion of service is through giving. Tithes and offerings can be sent to Pastor John P. Sheckett Jr. at 40 Owen Circle, Selden, New York. That's 11784. Please make your checks or money orders out to Mount Moriah Community Church. Or you can give through the Zelle app. That is Z-E-L-L-E app. It's going to ask you to enter in a phone number, which will be 631-617-1362. Excuse me. Through the Zelle app, you can give. By giving, enter in the number 631-617-1362. Any questions, you can definitely email us. If you've missed a service or two, no fear, no worry. Nothing like technology. You can catch up at the YouTube channel. Enter in Mount Moriah Community Church, and there you can catch up with all our previous services that we've had. Oh, I like that one. Keep calm and call your pastor. That's all right. That's all right. Yes, you can. You can call Pastor John today if you like, or anytime during the week. He can be reached at 631-617-1362. We thank God for that. Amen. Thank you for listening to our announcements this morning. And right now we're going to have our scripture reading by our Pastor John. Amen.
Amen. And we would like to thank God for once again, each and every one of you attending our service. the virtual service, which has already been spoken, Mount Moriah Community Church. Welcome to each and every one of you. Our scripture lesson this morning is coming from 2 Timothy chapter 3, verses 1 through 9. This know also that in the last days perilous times shall come. For men shall be lovers of their own selves, covetous, boasters, proud, blasphemers, disobedient to parents, unthankful, unholy, without natural affection, truth breakers, false accusers, incontinent, fierce, despisers of those things that are good, traitors, heady, high-minded, lovers of pleasures more than lovers of God, having a form of godliness, but denying the power thereof. From such turn away. For of this sort are they which creep into houses and lead captive silly women laden with sins, led away with divers lusts, ever learning and never able to come to the knowledge of the truth. Now as Jannes and Jambres withstood Moses, so do these also resist the truth. Men of corrupt minds, reprobate concerning the faith, but they shall proceed no further, for their folly shall be manifest unto all men, as theirs also was. Amen. Right now we're going to ask our Elder Rhonda if she would offer up this morning's prayer.
Father God, in Jesus' name, it's one more time we're able to meet together as a group. We are so grateful, oh Father God, for binding us together with your holy cords, which cannot be broken. We thank you for this day, a day that we'll never see again, that we can glorify you in all day long. For truly, this is the day that the Lord has made. We have chosen to rejoice and be glad in it. We thank you for the gift of the day and the gift of one another. We thank you for the gift of salvation, the shed blood of the Lamb, who has washed our sins away and has made us acceptable back to thee, Father, for how you love us, how you take care of us, how you provide for us. We thank you for our present state of health. And Lord, those that we need to pray for, that you heal, asking you to be the doctor on the case. If they do have a natural doctor, guide their mind and their heart, oh Father God, that they don't make any error or mistake concerning your vessels, oh Father God. Lord, if those that need a lawyer, an attorney, Jesus, you have never lost the case, never lost the battle. We continue just to keep ourselves submitted and committed into your hands to fight our battles for us, oh Father God. Oh, truly, if God is for us, it doesn't matter who's against us. Oh, Father God, continue to bless the service. Send your power, 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 your anointing. Oh, give your unction to Pastor John Pierce. Check it today. Tailor the message to the need of each person listening in. Take hold of his mind, his tongue, oh Father God. Just anoint, anoint, anoint. You speak, oh Father. It's inside. Bring it out. Bring it out that you are glorified. Undertake for us now in Jesus' name. Amen and amen.
God bless you, Elder Rhonda, for that. What can I say? God inspired prayer. Thank God for his presence, as it has already been said. And we're looking for God to speak to us this morning. He speaks to us every day. If you're listening, he speaks to us. Open up that word. Read a scripture. Pray. God wants to commune with us every day. And I thank God for this opportunity for during our testimony and scripture reading and song. I'm going to ask those to please be prepared when I call your name to unmute yourself. And again, once after you have read or sung a song, please mute yourself again, because again, when everyone is open, it interferes with the service, all right? And we don't want to prolong and drag out the service. So please be ready to unmute yourself and to, again, mute yourself. All right, I see so many faces. I am just so blessed to be in the house of God, family, friends, Oh, gee, God is awesome this morning. I see that God has kept us all, and I'm sure somebody has something to say. I've spoken enough, and I'm going to open this up to whoever wants to say something this morning. I don't want to overlook anybody. Please take advantage of the chat box to say, yes, I would like to say something. That would just make it easier for me to look over and see. We can unmute you, or you can unmute yourself, and you can give what God has given you a place on your heart this morning. God bless. I know I'm going to call on our Sister Smith. Last week, she was having a little difficulty with unmuting herself, and I think she got it all under control this morning. Am I right, Sister Smith? Amen. Sister Smith. All right, I'm going to come back to her. Like I said, I'm not going to keep going over and over. If someone has something to say this morning, definitely. Elder Rhonda, I know you always have something to say. I know you just prayed, but I'm going to ask you to open up our testimony service this morning.
Absolutely. I'm going to say Psalm 134 again, and I'm going to give up this little testimony to try to encourage our hearts just to trust God. First, I'm coming from Psalm 134. It's only three verses. Behold, bless ye the Lord, all ye servants of the Lord, which by night stand in the house of the Lord. Lift up your hands in the sanctuary and bless the Lord. The Lord that made heaven and earth, bless thee out of Zion. Well, praise the Lord. By me being attached to the Lord, you know how it is written, the just shall live by faith. During the course of the winter, well, if God meant for me to be in glory, I would have been there. But it seems like my chimney, which I didn't know was the chimney, but anyway, I was without heat. But it was because of the chimney. The chimney needed to be clean. And God bless, my brother gave me the name of a person. I made, praise the Lord, an appointment. And we were raving because he said it was only $50 to have it assessed. Well, they came in, and less than 5 minutes, it went from $50 to $3,000. So I said, well, I will get back to you. And you know the scripture that says, God is a very present help in the time of trouble. Well, I immediately called my son. Thank God for my son. Thank God for my brother, little sis, my family, far and near, Danielle, for each one. But I thank God, I immediately, when I got back to that office, I put my son on it to get me some more names. And I started calling. I wanted everybody's review from the Better Business Bureau and get this review. I made the other appointment. Anyway, it's scheduled. I did not have this amount of money, and I figured it was going to be a lot. God bless, my house is 90 years old, so you can expect me to rebuild everything in the house. So I said, Lord, you are a very present help in the time of trouble, and my pocketbook's in trouble because I don't have this amount of money to lay out for this thing that's needed. Well, God, who said he would supply all of our needs, did just that. He supplied the need to have it done, and it's scheduled to be done the day after Labor Day. Amen. To God be the glory.
God bless. That's right. That's all right. Very present help. All you got to say is help, Lord.
That's glory. It. That's all. Amen. 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 And he opens up that door. That same way you serve him, he comes right back. And I'm telling you, he provides for you.
Yes, he is.
Trust him. Have faith in him.
Jehovah Jireh. That is
amen.
Amen. God bless you, sis, for that testimony. Anyone else this morning? You can wave your hand or you can unmute yourself. Chloe and Austin. I know. You got something. Go right ahead. Okay. Right up, Junior, right after Austin and Chloe, you're next, okay? Thank you. Thanks, Junior. Go ahead, Chloe.
Hey, guy, 2:15:19. And now I pray you, consider from this day and upward, from before a stone was laid upon a stone in the temple of the Lord, since those days were, when one came to an heap of 20 measures, they were but 10. When one came to press back, or to draw out 50 vessels out of the press, there are about 20. I smote you with blessing and with mild dew and with hail and all the labors of your hands. Yet ye turn not to me, saith the Lord. Consider now from this day and upward, from the 24th day of the 9th month, even from the day that the foundation of the Lord's temple was laid, consider it. Is to see it in the barn, yea, as yet the vine, and the fig tree, and the pomegranate, and the olive tree, have not brought forth, from this day will I bless you.
Amen. Thank you, Sister Chloe. Go right ahead, Brother Austin.
Psalms 11, 4 and 7. The Lord is in his holy temple, the Lord's throne is in heaven. His eyes behold, his eyelids try the children of men. For the righteous Lord loveth righteousness, his countenance doth behold the upright.
Amen. God bless. Thank God for the word. Thank God. It's true in itself. Amen. Go right ahead, Brother John Jr. McBride. Good morning to you. Unmute yourself.
Good morning. I got a problem with my camera, so I can see y'all, but I can see me.
That's all right. But you know what
I want y'all. I want to know I'm here with y'all in prayer and in spirit, and I want to keep in your prayers because these technology I got here and I work properly. I don't know why, but I'm feeling good this morning.
Praise God.
I'm in a good state right now, so I need to pick me up from church. I need to church prayers and everything. So y'all keep me in your prayers, and I'll always keep y'all in mind. And I'll love all of y'all.
Yes,
sir. And y'all take care of everything. Like I got to take care of y'all, take care of me, take care of y'all.
But amen.
God, take care of everybody. So I love y'all.
Yes. God bless you, John. You've been through a lot, but that's all right. God has never left you. Even when we're not in his will, he still is with us. Somebody's praying for us. Somebody is praying for us. Be encouraged. Be encouraged, Brother John. Be encouraged. Hang on. Like I said last week, Jesus is your best friend. He's your best
friend. Yes, he is. Yes, he is.
He will never leave you. We mess up, but that's all right. All you have to do is ask God to forgive you. That's it. Praise God. He loves us. Be encouraged, John. Be encouraged. God bless you. Anyone else this morning? Oh, Deaconess. Yes, go right ahead, Deaconess Sproul.
Can you hear me?
Yes, we can. Woohoo! Yes, we can.
Yeah, thank the Lord for being here today. I know they started out this morning and it didn't work right, you know. I thank the Lord that we have a way. Hallelujah.
Yes, that's right.
Hallelujah. You get through. Hallelujah.
That's all
thank
right.
The Lord for being here today. Thank the Lord for this kind of glory. Thank the Lord for our Elder Runda. Thank the Lord remind me of my soul and my basement. I thank the Lord. We have a way, hallelujah, to give it to us. Have a remnant in the bush, hallelujah. He give it to you and give it to you. Sometimes give you, but thank the Lord. The time, hallelujah, you have money to pay for. He give you money. And I thank the Lord today.
Amen.
Stick with Jesus, hallelujah. He is the one. He have all the money in the world. And I thank the Lord today for the pan down on the thing that we put in the basement in Japan every month. So, you know, God gives you money. Hallelujah. You might not have what you want sometimes, but God, you know, fix it. Hallelujah.
Yes,
make the payment. Hallelujah. And make the reason for your pain. And I thank the Lord he is able to fix it. Whatever you can do, I thank the Lord for our Pastor Harris. Thank the Lord. And she's still waiting for the humble people very y'all continue to pray for, you know, because it's a mess for the COVID-19. The Lord able to fix it, he able to get it going. He able to, you know, to fix it so he can get it buried. And that's pretty much pray for my family. Hallelujah. Because you know, things that seem to go one way, then you come back another way. But God, keeping on control. That's pretty much my strength in the Lord.
Amen. Definitely, Deacon Spruels. We would have Pastor Harris on our prayer list, all right? And of course, your family as well. Be encouraged. Yeah. Don't forget to mute yourself, okay? God bless. I believe I saw Sister Blunt, you were unmuted. I didn't know whether or not you wanted to say something this morning. You can unmute yourself if you can.
Praise God. I'm having a problem with my phone, but I don't know if all y'all can hear me. First of all,
yes,
praise God, Brother Jeff, first lady, Sister Jay. Can you hear me?
Yes, we can hear you.
Because I'm going out, and Mount Moriah, all the mothers, Zion and Mount Moriah family, love you, bless you. We're one more week in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
God. I want to read Psalm 1, King James Version. Hold on. I'm going into my app. Get used to using this. All right. I'm going into King James, Psalm 1. This is a man that walketh not in the counsel of the ungodly, nor stand in the way of the sinners, nor sit in the seat of the scornful. But his delight is in the law of the Lord, and his law doeth, he meditate day and night, and he shall be like a tree planted by the water, that giveth forth fruit and season. He also shall not wither, and whatever he doeth shall prosper. The ungodly are not so, but are like the chaff which the wind driveth away. Therefore, the ungodly shall not stand in the judgment, nor sit in the congregation.
Amen.
The righteous. For the Lord knows the way of righteous, but the way of the ungodly shall perish. May the Lord have a blessing to his word and edification of my soul.
Amen.
In Jesus' name I pray. I thank so much. For let come through, and God bless the whole family, Mount Moriah. I'm going back to mute. Bless you.
God bless you. Love you, Sister Blunt. Love you. God bless you. Thank you so much. Oh, Cousin Cynthia?
Yes.
Are you going to say something this morning? You just muted yourself.
I thank God. For you, Jackie, for Pastor John Percy Shuckett, and I love to hear my cousin Rhonda pray. And just pray for, I have seven kids, but there are two that I'm very concerned about, Rhonda and Rudy. Just lift them up in prayer because I keep them on the altar. But I pray for all of them, and God has answered many prayers.
Amen.
I prayed for their marriages, and God kept them together.
Mm-hmm.
Rhonda is the only one that didn't finish school and made terrible choices, and she's on Section 8, and her landlord is trying to get her kicked off, but I'm trusting and believing God she'll get to stay on.
Mm-hmm.
Rudy is called and anointed of God, makes good money, but I don't know where his money is going. He refuses to admit that he has any kind of a drug problem. So, you know, but I do know that he used to drive with a suspended license, and every time I turned around, he was in court and having to pay court fees and lawyer fees. But I'm believing that this year he's going to get established, and he's the one that helps me. I'm there for him financially, and he's there for me. And
all right.
Every time he asks me for something, he gives me back double. So I thank God for that, because he is a blessed child. And when he used to play the drums for the church, the anointing would be on him so much that the anointing would fall on others. And because of the things we went through with my husband and his family, it kind of caused them to take a long time to recuperate from that.
Mm-hmm.
But God is good.
Yes, he is.
Mm-hmm.
Yes, he is. Thank you so much for sharing. Cousin mm-hmm. Cynthia, you didn't have to do that. You know,
I don't mind telling on the devil.
Well, there you go. There you go. And guess what? We are all going through something. Yeah. None of us have arrived. Just because we may be saved doesn't mean that our children automatically are saved and everything is going well and doing good and praise the Lord. That's not always the case.
That's right.
We do know this, that God is with us.
Yes.
He didn't say that we wouldn't go through. Didn't say that our children wouldn't be acting up.
That's right.
But that is something to cause us to really fall down on our knees and look to God. Because if everything went so rosy, we know we would not be praying like we should be.
That's right.
So there's a reason for everything. God bless you in you persevering. Continue to lift up your children in prayer. And we will do that as well. God bless you. Thank you so much for sharing. Thank you so much.
I love y'all so much.
Thank you so much.
I appreciate you guys a lot.
Well,
I'm so glad that y'all are on Zoom. You know, this thing happened for a reason. We can't go to the churches we used to go to, but this has been a blessing in disguise.
Yeah.
I haven't seen my family from New York and decades, and now I get this fellowship with you guys every Sunday. So I am so grateful.
God is good. He knows how to bring us together.
Yes,
he knows how to bring us together. And that great day. All right now. God is awesome. I praise him. I praise him every time. He's worthy of our praise. Anyone else? You can unmute yourself right now. I don't want to overlook anyone. Sister, I'm going to look for some phone numbers here. I see Sister Whitley. Are you ready? Go right. Okay, I see you unmuted yourself. Go right ahead.
Good morning, Aunt Mariah.
Good morning.
Listen to Elder Rhonda's testimony. I found John chapter 12 and verse 26.
Mm-hmm.
And I thought, promise from God and how he's fulfilled it.
Yes.
He said, if anyone serves me, let him follow me. And where I am, there my servant will be also.
Mm-hmm.
Anyone serves me, him, my Father, will honor.
All right.
All of us. May God add a blessed word to his blessed saying.
Amen. Thank you for that. What was that again? What was that? What scripture did it come from?
That's John chapter 12, verse 26.
Okay. You know I'm writing it down.
I know it.
God bless you, Sister Whitley. We love you. We love you. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Sister Smith. I see your number. We're going to have to do a little Zoom homework with you, Sister Smith. Sister Davis, are you there? All right, that's all right. We're going to move right along, as I said. Sister Wendy, I see you there. I see you now. All right. Okay. I got to say this about Sister Wendy. We love Sister Wendy. We love but I just thank her for her faithfulness. She has been with us several Sundays, which is usually rare because of what she works on Sunday. So it is indeed a pleasure to see you this morning. God bless you. And I know you got a good scripture for us today. Go right ahead.
Good morning. And yes, I was even with you last Sunday on my phone.
I saw.
you saw me? Okay. Good morning, church. I just want to say the Lord hears his people when they call on him for help. He rescues them from all their troubles. Psalms 34:17.
Amen.
I've had to call on the Lord. Well, I've called on him all my life, but I've had to call on him more this week than
usual.
I had a long time. Sister Rhonda had asked me to help her cousin to obtain her medicine, her 90-year-old cousin in upstate. And she'd never been a patient at CVS, I didn't have an insurance. I got her to get her insurance card. She couldn't find the right number.
Oh, my.
But this lady, Shirley Johnson, she's a sharp lady. I told her to get her Medicare card. She got that card. She read me the numbers off of it. She kept telling me the insurance she had. I took the numbers. I called the store. We put in her Medicare numbers. We found her insurance. I ordered her medicine.
Uh-huh. That's all right.
So, Sister Robinson told me that I was going to be blessed on many levels, but I've already been blessed, and it was my pleasure to help her.
Oh, God bless you. God bless you.
God bless the churches. Thank you.
Yes.
God bless you, Wendy.
God bless you. Thank you so much. God bless you for your faithfulness, Sister Wendy. God bless you for your faithfulness. I see our Sister Annie. Is that Sister Annie Jackson?
Good morning.
Good morning.
Good morning, all saints. I'm having technical difficulties. Y'all know these phones, and we older generation, we don't get along too well sometimes.
That's all right.
I was struggling last Sunday. I could hear you, but I couldn't see. And I wanted to know, do we get a different link number every week, Sister Jackie? Yeah,
yes, you have to be careful. Oh. Make sure you read the numbers and take down the information, because it depends on who is hosting. Today, Dr. Danielle Stewart is hosting. I'll be hosting next week, so there's going to be a different number. So please, I'm glad you mentioned that, Sister Jackson. Please look at the information that we send you every week. It may vary.
Because I think I haven't received any communication from you. What I have, I get it indirectly from Leticia or the girls.
Okay, what you could do, Mother Jackson, I will call you after service, or you can text me your email, or however you want me to communicate with you. I'll be glad to send you an invite.
All right.
All right. Love you. And we thank you for your gift offering. We received it. God bless you.
I love you all. I have a scripture I wanted to share.
Go right ahead.
From Psalms 150 about praise.
All right.
Praise ye the Lord. Praise God in the sanctuary. Praise him in the firmament of his power.
Yes.
Praise him for his mighty acts. Praise him according to his excellent greatness.
Oh, yeah.
Praise him with the sound of the trumpet. Praise him with the psaltery and harp. Praise him with the timbrel and dance.
Amen.
Praise him with stringed instruments and organs. Praise him upon the loud cymbals. Mm-hmm. Praise him upon the house sounding cymbals. Let everything that hath breath praise the Lord. Praise ye the Lord.
Yes. Amen. That's a sermon in itself. We can shut down right now.
Praise him. Praise him. Hallelujah. Praise him.
Go ahead. You go right ahead. I'm going to give you a couple of minutes. You go ahead and praise him, Sister Jackson.
Oh, I just praise him for his greatness, his mercy, and his greatness.
Oh, my.
He just gives us grace. We are all awake this morning, able to do this.
Yes.
Able to walk with our eyes open.
Amen. Praise.
There's so many we need to remember. A lot of us, some lay down last night and their eyes didn't open this morning.
That's
so
right.
This time he gave us this another day.
Thank you, Jesus.
This infinite time that we in. Yesterday is gone. Tomorrow isn't come yet. Right now, let's praise him.
Go right ahead, Mother Jackson.
It's so wonderful to be able. This is such a blessing that he has, this provision that he has provided for us to meet like this. It is such a blessing.
Yes, it is.
Because we need this. It's spiritually food. We encourage and uplift each other. That's what we need. We need this to be in touch.
Yes.
We can't touch physically, but we're touching mentally and spiritually.
All right now.
Spiritually, we're touching. And we need this. Encourage each and every one. Tell everybody we hold our heads up.
Yes.
Stay on our knees and ask for forgiveness, Lord.
Yes.
And we hibernate and hide and quarantine ourselves a little longer, Lord, waiting for you to move in your time.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Enjoyed your Sister Jackson this morning. Thank you. Thank you so much. God bless you. God bless you.
God bless everybody.
Sister Moore. Now, you know I didn't forget you. Go right ahead. Thank you, Pam.
Who's new?
You.
Oh, I am? Should I speak?
Yes.
Yes.
Okay, I'll just say in Psalm 71, a little of that, the prayer of an aged man. In thee, O Lord, do I put my trust.
All right.
Let me never be put to confusion. Deliver me in thy righteousness and cause me to escape. Incline thy ear unto me and save me. Be thou my strong habitation, whereunto I may continuously resort. Thou have given commandments to save me, for thou art my rock and my fortress.
Yes, he is.
Amen.
Amen. God bless you. Thank you so much, Sister Moore. We miss you. I miss that phone.
Quite welcome.
God bless you. Brother Matthew, I'm so sorry, hon. It's good to see your name. I would love to see your face, but that's all right. We love you, Sister Brother Matthew. We miss you. I pray all is well. Go right ahead. Brother Matt.
Hello?
Yes, we can hear you. Go right ahead, hon.
Hey, how you guys doing?
We're doing all right. How are you?
I'm good. I'm good. Praise the Lord. I'm just in Virginia in this heat. I'm doing well. Thank God. I work at McDonald's now.
That's all right.
It's a stressful job. I work with the public every day. But
don't tell me about it.
I thank God for keeping me safe from this virus and everything. And I hope you guys are doing wonderful.
Oh, we love you, Matt. We love you. We love you. God bless you. Stay with God. Stick with God. He's your best friend. You're never alone, Matt. Never alone. Okay? Yes. We are praying for you and your family. And
yes,
your father.
You.
And your mother and sister. The whole family. Thank you so much for joining us on your day off. We love you, Matt.
Love you guys, too.
Love you. Anyone else? Please unmute yourself. I just feel like it's going once, going twice. All right. I hope I didn't overlook anybody. Please forgive me. My mom, Mother Parks, you want to say something? You'll be the last one.
Oh, I will. Well, I just want to, there's a scripture that I've been pondering over, Lamentations 3:40.
Uh-huh.
Let us examine our ways and test them, and let us return to the Lord.
All right.
None of us have arrived as yet. I don't care how old you are, and I'm at an age now I don't have no business of looking at nobody else but me. Thank God for his mercy. Oh, if it had not the Lord been on our side, where would we be today? He's kept us this long for a reason. We're here for a reason.
That's so right.
Age don't mean anything. You just have to know how to touch the Lord. And it says, Lord, search me, O God, and know my heart, which he knows our hearts. You can't fool nobody. You can fool me, but you can't fool God.
All right.
See if there are any changes I need to make today as I seek to know you more and serve you better.
All right.
Thank God for Jesus.
Amen. And for his word. Amen.
Amen.
Hey. Thank you, Mom. Mom Parks.
Yeah.
Praise you. We're going to end on that scripture right there. That's, again, we had service already, but that's all right. We're ready for the dessert this morning. We thank God for the testimonies, the scriptures. I will have to get to my good friends, Sister Smith and Sister Davis, again later. I was hoping to hear from them. I hope they hear us. I know they do. But we love you. Don't be discouraged, Sister Smith or Sister Davis, if we didn't hear your testimony. God hears your testimony. Right now, we're going to go into our service, our sermon. Right now, I'm going to turn it over into the hands of Pastor John. Amen.
Amen. It's good to be back. Listening to all of the testimonies and the scriptures, It's wonderful to hear each and every individual who has testified this morning once again. It's always an encouragement to my soul to see how much God is doing for each and every one of us. And as we start with our service this morning, the running for my life is what the word is going to talk about this morning. And we've been running ever since we've been born. Our scripture lesson this morning comes from the book of Hebrews. Hebrews chapter 12, starting at the first verse. And it reads like this: Wherefore, seeing we also are compassed about with so great a cloud of witnesses, let us lay aside every weight and the sin which doth so easily beset us, and let us run with patience the race that is set before us. Everyone is a part of the race. It depends on how you're running, what direction you're running in. We know for the Christian, we're running in that race that leads to eternal life. But this race for some is long. All of us are not going to live a short life. Some of us live a very long life through the grace and mercies of God. His word tells us that our time is 70 years, 70 years, 70, and if by reason of strength he gives us more than that, then that's his grace and his mercy. And so once again, it's God's blessing upon man to be able to live this life at all, but it's his power in our life is how we're living it. But he tells us in this word that this race is the lifelong test of faith in this world because of all of the things that come up against us. That's the test to see whether or not you will survive the test. And this happens to us each and every day. The race must be run with patience, with perseverance and endurance. I remember when I used to run track in high school, I used to run what they call cross country. And before the cross country season, our coach would have us run a 2-mile race to not only keep in shape, but to get in shape. And this was new to me. I had just joined the track team. And I was running the race, and I didn't know how fast to run it because I didn't want to run out of gas. I didn't want to not be able to finish. So I just hung back. I stayed with the pack, as it were, the crowd. And so the coach saw that I wasn't doing what he saw me do in practice, because we were running this race against another school. So he shouted out to me to push it out. Called me by name and told me to push it out. And when he called me by my name and told me to push it out, I moved ahead of the person that was in front, and I just started to run. I was running and running and running, and before I knew it, I had a half-track lead on everybody. I looked behind me, there was nobody there. And because there was nobody there, I felt, what's the need in running? I felt like dropping out of the race. I started feeling sick. I started feeling cramps. I started feeling all of these different things that happen to you when you're running a long distance race. That's the same kind of race that we're running, church. The supernatural race of life. Troubles, trials that want to tell you with inside of yourself, what's the use? I can't do what I used to do. Time for me to leave. It's time for me to give up. Well, I kept hearing shouting from my other teammates for me to press on, press on, press on. And that's what God is telling us, to press on. Don't give up. Press on, press on until you get to the finish line. And sure enough, I eventually got to the finish line. I won the race. I had a half-track lead on everybody, but it was because of those on the sideline, those praying for you, those encouraging you to press on in the race of eternal life. Don't give up. Don't give up. The enemy wants you to give up. Trials and tribulations come our way to test our faith, to test our endurance, to see whether or not we will do what the devil wants us to do, which is to throw in the towel. Because sometimes things do get rough, church. And this body sometimes goes through some stuff and you wonder, how in the world can you make it the next day? God says, trust in the Lord and in the power of his might and lean not unto your own understanding, and you will see what I will do for you. Isaiah 40 and 31 says, but they that wait upon the Lord shall renew their strength. They shall mount up with wings as eagles. They shall run and not be weary, and they shall walk and not faint. God is telling us through the scriptures that when you rely on God, he will give you what you need. I talk to God from time to time when my body seems to feel that it can't go like it used to go. And I ask him, I said, Lord, I need some strength from you. I need some of your power to move me to get this body to be able to do what it does not want to do. And God, in his grace and his mercy, you know, will lead you to something either to eat, to drink, or just himself alone. However way God wants to fix it for you, he will fix it. But the thing is to reach out to him. Whatever your difficulty is, God is always looking to have you reach out to him, because he's the solution to all our problems, right? He's the solution to everything. I've heard testimonies as to, yes, our children, we can raise them right, raise them in the church. We can do all that we can do. The word of God tells us to train up a child in the way that they should go, and they will not easily depart thereof. It's still hidden in there someplace. The devil's trying to cover it up for those that were raised in the church and might have gone astray or might not be doing what we want them to do or what you know they should be doing. And they have allowed the enemy to cover that part of their life up. But they know. They still know the difference between right and wrong. Just that they don't have power. They've allowed the enemy to steal the joy and power of the Lord out of their life. And we have to pray and ask God to restore that joy in their life. That joy of the Lord is what's going to bring them back. So here we have a fight that we have to fight every day, church. I know we come to church once a week, but the fight is every day. So what are you doing when we're not in church? Where are you getting your inspiration from? Because we all need to be inspired. The Word of God inspires us. I told you last Sunday, get that Bible off the shelf, dust it off if it's got dust on it, and start doing what you should have been doing all along, which is reading the Word. That's where you're going to get your encouragement and your strength from. The Bible tells us in verse 2 of that scripture in Hebrews, looking unto Jesus, the author and finisher of our faith, who for the joy that was set before him endured the cross, despising the shame, and is set down at the right hand of the throne of God. Well, it's the same for us. We are looking past, or we have to be, or we should be looking past what we're going through in this life to the joy God says, I have prepared for those that love me. He says, there's a place for you. I already have it set up for you, but it's for those that love me. Like Jesus, he looked past all of the pain he knew he was going to have to go through, all of the suffering, all of the shame, because he knew what the end result was going to be. He was going to be on the right hand of his Father in glory for eternity. What are you looking past? Are you looking past your circumstances to the joy of the Lord? That's what's going to get you through. Because these trials that enter into our life, as the scripture told us, these things weigh us down. These are weights. These things take our heart and our mind away from what we should be doing, which is rejoicing in the Lord and in the power of his might. As that scripture says, laying aside every weight and the sin which does so easily beset us. Circumstances, I heard Elder Rwanda talk about the circumstance with her house. Deaconess Spruill with the circumstance at her house. It could be natural circumstances, it could be spiritual circumstances with a family member, a friend. We have a neighbor next door that we spoke to yesterday, and she had to go into the hospital for an epidural. Turns out that her knee, when they x-rayed it, is what was causing the pain of her not being able to walk. And so all of these things are there to besetting us every day. Something that's, whether it be the physical part of us or the mental stress and strains. I mean, you get bills that come in the mail, you thought you paid it already, and you're wondering why they're sending you another one. It's because the last bill, the check bounced, and so they're sending out another bill. I mean, or the bill that you can't pay because it's now too expensive. I don't need to get into health insurance. That's just over the top. But all of these things are things that weigh you down. We have to learn how to trust in the Lord. Scripture is trying to get us to that place in life, church, where we totally trust in the Lord. He's our waymaker. I heard that in the testimony, right? He's our waymaker. And whatever circumstance or situation that you're in, God will provide a means and a way to get out. You don't see it, you don't know it. And that's the way God is, because if you saw it, then you wouldn't have or be able to get the faith that you need to have in the God that you say you love. He does things to us coming out of left field to let you know, oh my Lord, that's got to be you, God, because there's no way I could have done that. There's no way it could have been done without you. And that's what God wants to hear from us. And that's why he does it the way he does it. So don't look for God to come the way you think he's going to come. He's not going to come that way. Another scripture I want to read to you comes from the book of Revelation, chapter 3, verse 21. To him that overcometh, will I grant to sit with me in my throne. Are you listening? This is the word of God telling us, if you overcome this life, this world, these struggles in this life, and you continue to trust God, love him, and pray to the God of your salvation, knowing that he's more than capable of taking care of whatever that issue is. He tells us in Revelation chapter 3, verse 21, to him that overcometh, I will grant to sit with me, with God, in my throne, even as I also overcame. This is Jesus, even though as he overcame. You remember Jesus had to overcome. You remember when he prayed to his Father in Mark 14, 36, and he saith, Abba, Father, all things are possible unto thee. Take away this cup from me. You remember that prayer he offered to his Father? But what did he say after that? Nevertheless. So we have to get used to saying nevertheless. I know you can do it, Lord, but nevertheless. Not my will, but thy will be done. So even Jesus was faced with all of these same circumstances and situations that we're faced in, and his word tells us how to overcome them. It's his word that encourages us to know that not only is he with you, and even if it doesn't, he doesn't take it away, he says, I am still with you. And you have to overcome that circumstance through your faith and belief that if I don't take it away, you know I can. You remember when Paul prayed to Jesus about that thorn in the flesh? Now, you know, if Paul is praying to God about the thorn, you know it must have hurt him pretty bad. It wasn't just an annoying prick in the finger. This must have been something that was really annoying him, and it took away from, no doubt, how he felt he wanted to or needed to be as he traveled and preached and taught the word of God. And he prayed three times for God to take this thorn in his flesh away. Now, this is a man that was healing people. This is the man that wrote most of the New Testament.
and he's praying to God, and he still has this thorn in the flesh. So what does Jesus do? Tells Paul, Paul, I don't want you to pray about that anymore, because I'm not going to remove that thorn from your flesh. Because my strength is made perfect in weakness. How about your thorn that you've been praying about? Praying and praying and praying and asking God to remove this thorn from your flesh. When Jesus speaks, we need to learn how to listen. My strength is made perfect in weakness. I have allowed this to be upon you, to test you, to try you. Remember what I read earlier from Revelation. To him that overcometh, will I grant to sit with me in my throne. If you're able to overcome that thorn in your flesh and still glorify me, still love me, still walk as if there was no thorn in your flesh, I will bless you to sit in my throne next to me for eternity. The world doesn't understand stuff like this. This makes no sense. If you're sick and you trust God to make you well, you should be well. That's not going to be always the case. And so the church, that you and I have to understand, it's got to be in God's will for it to be so. And not to be upset about it. When God heals one and not another, God has his reasons, his purpose is always perfect. We have to rely on that. The devil doesn't want you to see it that way. He wants you to get upset with God because of what you're feeling or what you're going through. Because God is a merciful God. And he is. And that's why he said, at the end of your days, you'll be with me in glory. Look past the thorn in the flesh to what I have prepared for you. Oh my, God goes on, the race must be run by laying aside the sins that impede or slow us down. Because that's what sin does, it slows you down. And by fixing our eyes, lives, and hearts on Jesus and the example of persevering obedience he set on earth. Again, Jesus was our example. In all things, he was our example. That's why you have to read his word to find out what he did. Now, here's God. Can you imagine God himself on earth, walking and talking with man, and man's arrogance to think that he knows more than what Jesus was telling them about salvation, about, well, life, because they thought that they knew more than this poor carpenter from Nazareth. The race must be run with an awareness that the greatest peril confronting us is the temptation to yield to sin. It's always there, church, because of our sinful nature. It's always there. And we've got to understand that. But yield not to temptation. To return to that country from whence you came out. There is a song that we sang in church. How did you feel when you came out of the wilderness? And that's what we always have to remember, church. How did you feel when you came out of being lost and now being found? Don't yield yourself to that temptation of this world and this life. And they, believe you me, there are plenty of temptations. The devil has a way of just smoothing things out in your mind to think it's okay. It's all right. You know, when the Bible says that wine is a mocker and strong drink is raging, and here we have so many people in the church still drinking wine and taking a strong drink. Yet God's word says that it's not going to help you. It's going to hurt you. But, you know, we compromise our faith by thinking that, well, I just need one. But one leads to two. It doesn't stay as one. And we start relying on the things of this world rather than on God himself to help us. And that's where we need to understand how important God's word is for us. In our race of faith, we look to Jesus as our example of trust in God, of commitment to his will. And that's through prayer, overcoming temptation and suffering, of endurance and loyalty to the Father, and of seeking the joy of completing the work to which God has called you to. Yes, it's a race. Endurance. This is a long race. And God is looking for you to endure, to put up with the cramps, put up with getting sick, until you come to the end of that race. For consider him that endured such contradictions of sinners against himself, lest ye be wearied and faint in your minds. Ye have not yet resisted unto blood, striving against sin. And ye have forgotten the exhortation which speaketh unto you as unto children. My son, despise not thou the chastening of the Lord, nor faint when thou art rebuked of him. Because whom God loves, he chastens, just like a parent who spanks the child because they were out of order. You didn't kill the child, you just disciplined the child. God does likewise to us, because he doesn't want you to perish. Chastening helps us. It's a sign that God loves us and doesn't just leave us to our own devices. So many people feel that, and you hear it by all of these people that, you know, that are in the world, and believe me, the world wants to go to heaven too. That's right, the world wants to, no one wants to go to hell. The problem with the world is they want to go to heaven their own way. They want to live their life their own way and still go into heaven. But God says that's not the way it's going to be. And so what does man do? They don't listen to the one who has control over heaven. And they still think that for some reason, God will wink at their sin, God will wink at their disobedience, and let them in. And God puts perfectly in his word, he will not allow sin to enter into his kingdom. It's not gonna happen. So when you hear about a rock star, or, you know, heaven's got all these rock stars in there, heaven's got all the actors and actresses that ever lived in heaven, you know, all of these people that when you see them on stage, you know, you automatically look and say, you know, there is no way, unless they repent before they leave here, that they have any access to heaven. But yet the people that come to their funeral or always say that, well, there's a new band member in heaven. And it's not so. It's not so. Whether it be somebody who's a celebrity or whether it be somebody in our own family who's not living right. God wants us to understand that this run, this race is run according to the word of God. We have to be on his track, doing it his way. So as we go through this life, church, I want you to understand, and as we run this race and endure the chastening of the Lord, yeah, I know nobody likes chastening, but once again, you'll understand it better by and by. And you'll thank God for whipping you instead of him just saying, all right, go ahead, do what you want to do, but you're going to end up going to hell for eternity. God doesn't want that to happen. God doesn't want to see you separated from him for eternity. So he works with us, church. And that's why for us today, run this race until there's no more reason to run it, because Jesus is calling your name. There's a song that I'm hoping to have played in the next couple of weeks. If I can remember the name. Oh yeah, Precious Memories. When you start thinking back on your life,
and the things that you have not just done. I'm not talking about the bad things now. I'm just talking about this life and how God has blessed you to get through it. You look back and you say, how was I able? It's through the grace and mercies of Almighty God. That's the only way we're able to get through this life, church. In that day when we can stand, God bless the soul that can stand before Jesus. And he says, well done, thou good and faithful servant. Enter into the joy of the Lord. God bless your souls. I pray that you got them. Excuse me. I pray that you got something out of the message this morning of running this race for your life. Because it's your life. Nobody's life but yours. I want to offer up a prayer or a prayer list before I pray. The list is getting longer and longer, and it will continue to get longer as we pray for the president, the hospital workers, the first responders, the missionaries, sick people under the COVID-19, the shut-ins, those who are depressed, alone, school system, everyone connected to it, those in nursing homes, jobless, homeless, unsaved, backslider, families, single parents, pastors and the churches, prayer warriors, intercessors, Mount Moriah Church family, those that are in the armed service, all of those that are on the Mount Moriah Community Church prayer list. If you know of someone who you desire to have on there, text us, write us, let us know. We'll put them on. And now I will offer up the prayer this morning. Precious Lord God Almighty, holy and true, we once again do praise and thank you, God. Thank you, thank you for your continued grace and mercy in our lives. You have truly, Lord Jesus, made the way, a way that we could not have made for ourselves. Help us to keep our eyes open and our ears, Lord God, ready to hear and our heart ready to receive your word into our life each and every day. My Lord and my God, you see what we're up against. We fight and we war against you, God, against you. We think it's against the person next to us, but it really is against you. We continue, Lord Jesus, to be disobedient in so many different ways, but I pray that you would look past all of our faults and continue to see our need, that Lord God, as we go through this life that you bless us with, we'll come out rejoicing in the God of our salvation. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Way. My God has spoken. I heard him. So let
let the church say, oh, lift your hands wherever you are and let the church say, amen, let the church say, God has spoken, hallelujah. Let the church say, all we needed was a word from the Lord. We've got it, so let the church say, oh, let the whole church say, God has spoken. Well, let the church, let the church say, let the church say, I need you to say, when you dreamed about to die, knowing that God is not a man, he just can't lie, in spite of what the devil does, know you've got a word that has come from above.
God bless. What a beautiful song to end the service. Let the church say amen. That can be hard to say sometimes when you're going through, to say amen. Because basically amen means so be it. It is whatever God's will is. Sometimes we don't understand what his will is, but we pray that God give us the courage to say amen and to trust him. Because that's basically what amen is saying. I trust you, Lord. I'm going through, but I trust you. And I thank God for his presence this day. Thank you once again for all of our friends, our family coming out to help us lift up God's name. We thank you for first-time guests and continue to keep us in your prayers as we continue to do this, these Zoom services. Again, it wouldn't be the same without you. If you're able to stay, we ask you to, especially those who are having difficulty with unmuting themselves and muting themselves, we would like for you to stay. Please, Dr. Danielle, could you just sort of explain what we're planning on doing in a little bit?
Yes, thank you, First Lady and Pastor John. Everyone, we are gonna do something fun today. We're going to actually set you all up in breakout rooms. And what that looks like is we're gonna have a room that is going to be for continued fellowship for those who wanna talk and catch up. And then we'll also have a praise party room where we'll continue the fellowship and the music that we had going on. So in the next 5 minutes, just look for the prompt on your screen and it'll tell you to join the room. If you don't join the room, that's fine. You can stay with me. If you join the room, you'll be with First Lady and Pastor. and continue the fellowship with one another. And you can tell your, you can press the button to keep the room at any time and come back to me, or you can go home. If you get kicked out for any reason, just log back in like you did earlier today, and you'll get back in with us, okay? All right, First Ladies, back to you.
But that's okay. Tell her I'll call her.
I think, Miss Cynthia, you're saying something?
Thank you.
I'm sorry, I have to go. I wish I could stay, so I hope you guys do this again next Sunday. I have to be someplace at 1 o'clock, and it's almost one.
Okay.
So, but it's right across the street. So I will, I'm going to visit a neighbor, and we already made plans. She's new to the neighborhood. So I wish I could.
God bless you, Cynthia.
Hi, Cousin Rhonda. Oh, I love you so much. I wish I could stay on. So I'm going to do this with you guys again next time, okay?
All right. Go and do your missionary work.
That's exactly what I think God has me doing. I'm only asking him to go with me and before me. Okay.
Spiritually, I will.
Okay. I love you guys.
Love you.
Bye-bye.
Bye.
First Lady, it's back to you. We'll split up in about 5 minutes.
Okay, I was on the phone with Sister Smith. She thought that the service was over, which technically yes, but I was encouraging her to come back so we can help her with the unmute and muting, as well as anyone else who would like to know how to do that. I know it's a little frustrating, but we want everybody to be able to participate. Everybody's not tech savvy, and we don't want them to be frustrated. We're grateful that you're able to hear us, but I know you would like to participate. So, but yes, we're gonna split it up. Those who wanna just hang out with me, you can. Those who need a little help, you can hang out with Dr. D, and we love you guys. Thank you for all for staying this long. We appreciate it. You can unmute yourself and voila. I think I missed something, didn't I?
No. Nope.
Did I miss something?
No, nope. Okay. I'm going to separate everybody in 5 minutes.
Okay. Thank everybody for coming. Thank you, Michelle. Love you. Praying for you. I hope mom is, you know, coming along. God bless you. You know, taking care of mom. That's a job in itself. We thank you for being here with us. We love you, definitely. It's open. If you have something to say, you definitely can. Thank you, John. John, yeah. Thank you for sticking around. God bless you. Thank you, Junior. Love you. Thank you, Glo. You came on a little early, Junior. God bless you. All right.
Well, I've been trying to get in because the tablet wouldn't work right. So
yeah, I think a lot of people were having difficulties. But you didn't give up. See, that's what it's all about.
Well, I would never give up.
No, you can't do that. It's too late to give up, Junior. You can't give up. That's what the Satan wants us to do. Like the message was, we're running this race to the end. So do you hang in there?
I can't run no more.
Yeah. Can you walk?
I can't walk no more either now.
You can walk. You can. All right. Well, crawl. If you could crawl, you could want to get the bike, get a wheelchair, whatever. You can. You hang in there. God bless you. Amen. I don't know who. Oh, there, Sister Smith. Sister Smith, can you hear me?
Yes. Hello.
Yes. God bless. Welcome back.
Yes, I hand you over to Mr. Yes, she is here.
Okay.
Okay. Yes. Hello.
Hi, Sister Smith.
Hello.
We can hear you now.
Did you hear me to start with?
No, we did not, because you were muted.
Because you know I sang Victory Is Mine.
Oh, we didn't hear you because you were muted, Sister Smith. But we can hear you now, Sister Smith.
Uh-huh.
We can hear you now.
Yeah, but I wanted to did y'all get my dues?
Yes, we did.
Okay.
God bless
you. Then what I'm going to do about that is not hearing you. I hear you now, but I don't know.
Sister Smith, you know something? We have a nice crowd of people still on the line. Why don't you share your scripture or song? We would love to hear you. And then Dr. Danielle is going to help you with unmuting and muting yourself, okay?
Well, what am I going to do now?
Well, if you can say, you can give your testimony. We're still having a little church right now.
Okay, all right. Victory is mine.
Uh-huh.
Victory is mine. Victory today is mine. Oh, I told Satan to get thee behind. Victory today is mine.
Uh-huh.
When I rode this morning, I didn't have no doubt. I know that the Lord will work it out. Well, I fell down on my knees. I said, Lord, help me, please. And I got up, shot in the victory.
That's all right.
I got a testimony. When in the beginning, you couldn't get me on the line. And two Sundays, I was left out. And then last Sunday, you couldn't get me. And this Sunday, I sang, but you say you didn't hear me.
Right, you were probably muted. You were probably still muted, Sister Smith.
Well, you know how to fix it.
Well, that's why I asked you to come on back to the service, and Dr. D is going to help you. Danielle Stewart is going to help you with that, okay?
Did you hear me then?
I'm hearing you now. That's why we're communicating. I hear what you said, and that's why I'm communicating with you, because I heard what you said.
Uh-huh.
And you hear us, right?
Yeah, I can hear y'all, everything.
And once again, I can hear you. You can hear me. That's good. You're unmuted.
Yeah, I hear you.
All right. And we can hear you.
Now.
Yes,
you
now.
You think it's going to stay?
Sister Danielle's going to help you with next week, okay?
Next week.
She's going to help you today for next week.
Oh, all right. Well, okay, let me know when you get ready for me to write something, because I'll let my aide write it.
I'll call you later.
Sister Smith.
Yeah?
Sister Danielle is going to call you, okay?
And she going to help me?
Yes, she will.
All right.
Okay?
Okay,
Don't give up, Sister Smith. You can't give up. We got to keep
giving up, because I thought everything was all right.
We got to keep giving the devil black eyes.
Mm-hmm.
All right? Hang in there.
Sister Jackie, there's so few of us on here, we don't need to go into separate rooms.
I guess not.
Y'all go ahead and finish talking, and then I'll play music after y'all finish.
All right now. All right. God bless. Good to see Brother Ralph. How you doing there, sir? I just see the top of your head, Brother Ralph. Now I see you. Now I see you. You got the unmute going? Woohoo!
Yeah, well, I enjoyed the service, you know.
Yes. So
I sit back and enjoy the service. I always like to hear Brother John when I call him Brother John.
That's all right.
Pastor John. I enjoyed, you know, because he seemed to articulate very well. You know, he got everything together. He keeps everything together. So I appreciate that, and I like to listen to him.
Oh, Well, we like to listen to you. That's why I always ask if you got something to say.
Because he gives me inspiration. Him and, well, in fact, the whole congregation, really, because I look forward to it every Sunday. You know, it's something that's there that I look forward to, and it's good when you have something to look forward to.
Amen. 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 That gets you up in the morning. Amen. Amen.
Yeah, and I thank God for that. I thank God for allowing me to be able to enjoy the service.
Yes.
So I'm going to leave now. give somebody else a chance.
Oh, that's all right. This is why we hang out after church. It doesn't matter. It's all right. You can stay on as long as you want. It's okay. This is that opportunity to share and talk a little longer, because you can't do that during testimony service.
Right.
That's something more to say. Here's your opportunity. You know, so that's what we want. Everybody to be free, feel free. You know, one big family. Amen.
Who was that?
Oh, who? Junior, you have something to say, Junior, again?
Who idea was that to do this? What you're doing now?
I thought it was my idea, because say it again, John.
Well, because we can talk more now, because during the service you can't say what you want during the service.
Right, right.
You're holding everybody.
By
doing this here, it will help people that need the help. You understand what I'm saying? It helps.
Mm-hmm.
That's what I like. I like it. You said that. I like to get on that too.
All right.
You can understand what I just said. The influence you give now is helpful, because I can hear you. I can see you. You can't see me, but
that's all right.
I feel happy. I feel good about everything.
You're going in and out, John. I can hear some of what you were saying, but yeah, I agree. This is a helpful time where you can share and open up if you want. You can.
Yeah.
And to know, as I often say, and we appreciate you, and we want you to know that you're not by yourself. Give us a call, John. You know, type in your little number on the side. We'd be glad to call you, check up on you. You know, and just to let you're not by yourself. You know, so
yeah, I get when Glow get home, I get from her. My sister.
Okay, no worries, no worries. I think she just left. She just said goodbye to everybody.
Yeah, I know she went on. She went on. I get the number from her, and she'll give it to me and put it on my phone.
Okay, sounds good.
All right.
Lady Shepherd.
Yes, ma'am. I can hear you, Sister Smith, yes?
Time to unmute.
Lady Shepherd.
Yes, Sister Smith.
Should I hang up or just wait till she calls?
I'm gonna call you later.
Yeah, you can you can stay around if you want, but she's gonna call you.
Oh, okay. That's why I don't have to worry about hanging up. Okay.
You can hang up.
I let her call and I'll stay by the phone.
All right. You can hang up and she's going to call
you. Yeah, I hear you now. I hear you.
All right now.
Okay. Well, I'll be sitting right here when she calls.
Okay. God bless you, Sister Smith.
Thank you.
You're welcome, hon. Love you.
Shepherd.
Talk to you later.
Okay. Bye.
Bye. God is so, yes, Carolyn, he is. God is awesome.
He's patient.
Yes. You know, he's patient with us.
Yes, he is.
Who am I? You know, and maybe one day when I get up in my 80s, I'm going to need a little help myself. I need some help now, but... But you just don't know. Life is a wheel.
Right.
That is it.
Life is a wheel. It comes around.
Yes, yes, indeed.
And I want somebody to be there for me.
I know that's with, right.
You know, seriously. I want somebody to be there for me when if I'm ever in need. Right?
That's right.
Good to see you, Pam. I missed you last week. You know, I was looking for you.
Uh-oh.
Gotta unmute yourself. There we go.
Okay, there we go.
Good morning, everybody.
Good morning.
Good afternoon, everybody.
Oh, yeah, that's true. Okay, I'll take it.
I missed you all as well last week. I don't know how to type it in, but I would like to share that we have an aunt here in Fayetteville, Georgia.
Fayetteville?
Yes. Her name is Joyce Batiste. And she is in her late 80s, early 90s, not quite sure, but her husband passed away last year.
Mm.
And she had three children, and out of the three, only two are living. One is living, excuse me. The youngest is living, which she's taking care of her mom. Her name is Ariane Batiste. So keep her in prayer because
Ariane?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay.
Ariane is the youngest daughter and the only living child. And she has been taking care of her mom throughout a lot. She is, like I said, in Fayetteville, Georgia. She just texted me yesterday stating that on 8/3 at about 1 a.m. in the morning, she had short of breath, had to be taken to the hospital until the 14th. She said that on Friday, had septus, internal infection, damaged kidneys and liver and heart. A blood clot in each lung caused congestive heart failure. Heart doesn't beat efficiently because fluid build up in the lungs. Home health care nurse came in to check her vitals. So that means she's home now, which is a blessing.
Mm-hmm.
That sure is a blessing.
Blood pressure.
Wow.
And respiratory was very low. So back after that, she had to go back into Piedmont Fayetteville Hospital between the intensive care regular wards. She says, Mom came through Thursday night very well. Friday morning was looking good, talking, and getting stronger.
All right.
Which is a blessing. And she said she'll keep us posted. So, and I told her Aunt Joyce is a tough cookie.
Sounds like it.
Yes, indeed. And to keep her lifted up in prayers, keep them all lifted, because it's plenty that they're going through, not just the struggles of health, but the struggles of the devil in their home, where a son-in-law of their deceased child has been very not nice. Let's put it like this. The devil has taken to a point where it's been rough on them just to know whether they're going to be still living in the same place. Let's put it like that.
Wow.
Because he feels that that's his home. So to make a long story short, just keep them all lifted in prayer.
Yes.
We do go visit as often as we can because the distance is not as far as it could be. But we do take it upon ourselves with the cousins to try to go visit them as often as we can.
Yeah.
And due to, of course, the circumstances with COVID, and her age, we have to stay apart right now. But the blessing is the daughter, they're allowing Ariane to stay in the hospital room with her mom. So that is a blessing. I just wanted to put that out there.
True.
And keep us all lifted as usual.
Yeah, definitely. Thanks for sharing, Pam. Can you spell Ariane's name?
This is how I spell it, and not that it's correct, but
that's
it's
okay.
A-R-I-A-N-N-E.
Okay, I got it. And Batiste is with the E at the end.
Yes, that is
okay.
Correct.
Okay.
Batiste is a B-A-T-T-I-S-T-E, I believe it's
spelled. Oh, two T's? Okay.
I do believe. Yes.
All right. Mm-hmm. Well, when you see the name, forgive me if I misspelled it, but you'll see it up there. All right. God knows.
Yes, he does.
Okay, even in the wrong spelling of the name, he knows
who. Yes, he does. And I tell everybody, forgive me for misspelling names, because sometimes it's not always correct. Mm-hmm. Even my grandnephew Colin, I know I didn't spell his name correctly. So when I wished him a happy birthday yesterday, I told him, please forgive me. I might not be spelling your name correctly. I'm spelling it the way I know how.
That's right. All right. That's all right.
Sounds like me.
Thanks for sharing, Pam. We appreciate that.
Yes, ma'am.
I just like people. People don't have to share. But when they share, that's, to me, that's saying, wow, I feel comfortable enough to share.
Yes.
There's no big I's, little U's. We all are going through something. No. And sharing just provides an avenue for prayer.
Amen.
More people to pray. You know, so.
And it definitely lets you know how much people are going through.
Yeah.
Yes.
Because you pass people on the street, you don't know what's going on in their life, but here you have a chance to testify. The testimonies is really to help somebody else.
That's true.
But also to help you. You're letting it out. You know, it's
therapy. Rather than
keeping it inside, you're letting it out.
It's
and
therapy.
I feel that with both of those things going on, not just letting it out, but also encouraging somebody else who might be going through the same thing, God has a way of ministering to us that goes beyond what we might consider normal. I mean, just you testifying to the goodness of the Lord and blessing her to come home.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
Just that testimony alone, God could use to touch somebody else's body to come home when they didn't think they were going to be coming home. You know, I mean, that's why you can't put a limit on how God works. Many different ways. Mm-hmm. And it's truly a blessing. And if I continue, I'll be preaching a second sermon. So
that's why I like to say something, cousins. This is Gail.
Yeah, we got you, Gail. We got you.
I wanted to clarify some things too, or add to what Pam was saying, to let you know exactly who that is. I'm not sure if you caught on, Piercy, who it was, but that's Grand Aunt Geraldine's son's wife that she's talking about.
Okay.
You know, you know what I'm talking about? Aunt Geraldine's son, Uncle Al. Well, we say uncle and aunt, but they're, you know, cousins, because they're our parents' cousins. So, talking about Cousin Al's wife, Joyce. Yes. And that they live, you know, in the house where what they were living with their daughter, Ava, and her son, and she passed. And, you know, so he's, like she said, is acting like he wants them to leave. So I just wanted to clarify that you knew that was our cousins, the Baptiste from King Street.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Mm-hmm. Okay, we're going to test something out. Just stay with us a little bit, and we're going to let you go, because this is just for testing. I know we've been here. We're going to have a go into next week, but we keep going this. But we are testing out, as Dr. D had said earlier, break rooms, where if you want to hang out with us, you can. We can chat. The other room will be for music or whatever you want to do. So we want to, if we don't mind you guys sticking around, so we can see how this works. I need to know how this works for next week. We appreciate that. So Danielle, take it away.
Okay, if you guys get kicked out, then just, you can log back in. But it is going to tell you you're going to enter into a room. You gotta click that button, okay?
Everybody got it? If you guys don't mind coming back so we can test this out. Sister Blunt, you with us?
Oh.
Carol, Stephanie. John Jr., I think that's Lisa Parks. All right, Aunt Earlene, Mom, you're gonna get kicked out, but come back in.
I'm gonna get it for 3 minutes, but you can come back at any time. All right, hold on.
Okay. You don't get, we're not kicking you out, we want you to come back, but you're gonna get kicked out.
All right, see you in a minute.
Okay. All right.
You can keep me.
No, John.
All right.
Okay. So.
But I got a mash.
I think she's going to kick us out.
Somebody's got it. Yeah. Some people have it.
Oh, so what? Should I join now?
Yeah. Did you get a prompt? It says.
Yeah, I did.
Go ahead.
John, you got a prompt?
Yep.
Come on in.
Some of you will be here with me.
Where I'm at?
You and me.
Oh, Lord.
Gala with me.
I want to join. I want to go into the meet with everybody.
Okay, there's just two rooms. So hold on, I'll put you in there. Let me see if I can. Did you click the button? It said to join.
I clicked later, I think, mistake.
Oh, okay. Hold on. It may not. Yeah, it says you didn't join. Let me see.
Maybe do it again.
Let me see if I can give you the request again. They'll be back in a couple of minutes. I don't think it's letting me give
you the option. I wanted to go into the meeting room with everybody.
Huh?
I'm in with you.
You're with me.
Daniel Stewart, I'm with you.
Yeah, I'm good. How are you?
Yes, I'm going to go with Pastor John and firstly Jackie.
I think what happened when you said later, won't let me give you the option.
Hit later.
Right. Hold on. Let me check. Let's see if I can get you back in here.
I'm breaking up now.
It's okay.
Okay.
You came back, Gail.
Yeah, I see you now. I hear you.
Okay, it won't let me put you back in because they're about to come back out. They're literally coming back out in like 30 seconds.
Can you hear me?
Yes, ma'am.
Can you hear me?
You can't hear me? Can you hear me now? My phone is mute.
Oh, it said my phone is mute. Yes, I can hear.
You saw people, Jack?
All right. A little. We're breaking up. Yeah, I'm breaking up.
You're muted, Jackie.
Let's see.
I guess my question was, what if you wanted to leave the break room? How would you do that? To go?
Yeah, it's the same where you say end or leave a meeting. It asks you if you want to leave the break room in that same area.
Oh, okay. 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 Gotcha. Okay. That's how
I wanted to add in the joining room with Pastor John and Sister Jackie something and through email. But can you hear me,
yes.
Mr. Stewart or Sir Jackie?
Yeah, we can hear you. Mm-hmm. We can hear you.
Okay. First of all, praise God for the beautiful message that came up with Pastor John and firstly, which is your sister. Yeah, I love you all. All right. I would like one email. If you can give my hearts, my sister more, other more.
Mm-hmm.
Deacon Glass and Sister Carol, my email, my number, and my address. And just hello to the Mother Zion. I you know, it's in my heart. And continue to pray for my husband Annie. Diabetes is really hit him up and down. To take needles, you know. And pray for me that I will lose this weight, that I will get this operation on my knee.
Okay.
Because I have to get a knee place.
Wow.
And that's because the arthritis did.
Okay.
You know. So, again, I thank God for all of y'all, Malraya. It's just the Holy Spirit led me back home.
Yeah.
And I truly praise God for that. My family, my children, Hope and Charity, and grandchildren. Send love. That's the reason why I asked you to get the numbers so I can share the photos and stuff. You know, okay. I didn't want to say all that, sir.
That's all right.
Prompts were due to everybody.
Right. And that's the whole purpose of this.
I can just, can you hear me, sir?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, that's
the
whole
Mr. Jack?
Yeah, I'm sorry. You're like in delay, but that's the whole purpose of this after service to share, because we can't really do a whole lot during, you know.
I understand.
Right. So this is an opportunity for you to share. Pam, you can leave us. You don't have to stay. Yes. But anyhow.
I don't want to be long-winded.
No. But this is your opportunity.
Yes, I love you all. I love so proud the evangelist, that's his sister. Stuart, I rave you something to me down the road. Are you from Ireland? From Jamaica Island? Cindy, I have that man name spelled the same way. Daniel, is that name Daniel Stuart? Evangelist Daniel Stuart?
Yeah, Daniel.
What's the question?
Is that you?
He calling you an evangelist.
Are you evangelist? In the island? are parents the island?
You don't remember me. I remember.
I'm going in history. Okay.
You remember me.
But my name, my maiden name is Stuart. It's spelled the same way. And he's my father, bless his soul. And he died. Gone. He's home with the Lord. Jamaican. I'm a descendant.
I'm
now I'm telling my whole life now. But God bless you all. I'm gonna let you know. I love you. I noticed that Carol sit here quietly. But you know, I'm gonna email you. And an email of your number. I really speak to other. Also, to all of you, God bless you. I love you. I'm gonna let you go. And one more thing. I want to send this offering because I'm having a little problem. You said Zell, and the number is 31617132. Bring up app and just the money, right?
You can. You can do it that way. If you're not comfortable doing that way, you can definitely send a check or money order.
I'm going to trade with the Zell. It doesn't come now, Mitch.
Oh, okay. Your connection, just right, to let sister. You know, is a little wobbly because you're coming in like delayed.
Okay.
It's not really clear, so I'm not sure. If that ever happens again, log out and come back in.
Yeah, we're coming in late. Yeah. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to let go. I'm going to disconnect the men. I'm going into hell to put an offering in. Love you all. God bless you.
Yes.
And bless the week.
God bless you.
Stay safe in Jesus' name.
God bless you. Thanks.
Bye.
Thanks, sis. Will do.
You too.
God bless you. Love you, love you, love you.
Stephanie, you still there?
Who?
Stephanie.
Yes, Stephanie's there.
Stephanie, where you at?
She's right there.
I'm here.
Girl, I've been waiting to play this song just for you, honey. Hold on.
Yes.
Woo.
Let's see Fred.
Need that. This is for you.
Uh-huh.
Can you hear it?
Hello, James.
Yes, I can hear it.
Okay, cool.
There was a blind man on the roadside, and he heard a commotion, yeah. It was Jesus passing by with a crowd, and he stirred his emotion. Oh, he'd been displaced his whole life. Could I ever save you? So I cry, Jesus, I need you.
Please don't pass me by.
I'm crying.
Now, why is that your favorite? Is that one of your favorite songs?
Yes, it is.
Yeah, the words are really, I love the words.
Yeah, me too.
Yeah, I like the song. The music is good too. It complements. It's not overpowering the message. And that is such an awesome song. Thanks, Stephanie. You go, girl. Gotta make you a DJ. What else you got?
Oh, okay. All right, this is for y'all.
That's all right. I love that. Thanks, Steph. I love you, hon, for sharing. That's all right.
You're welcome.
Here, Steph, this is another one for you. Good.
What's that? Who that? Who that?
That's for me, honey. Kirk Franklin.
Oh.
That's for me.
Ooh.
Doors you've closed just for me.
That's all right, y'all.
Sometimes you will say no, so I'll be tested in your fire to purify my desires. So my blessings won't be just for me.
Right now.
When myself I never see.
Uh-huh.
The world did not pay all around me. So storms are in your will, so I can feel what others feel. Because it don't feel good.
Nope.
It never does. It don't seem fair.
Uh-huh.
Don't seem fair.
You to call this love. Necessary pain,
yeah.
The ingredient of change. Either way, life may be bittersweet, it's working just for me. All the moments I missed out just for me. Because I chose not to wait patiently.
This is a cute thing.
Every mistake. Amount of grace,
yep.
And kept my blessing away for me. Trusting your timing is not easy.
Well, what's not always what I mean? Oh, I forgot. So I forgot. I deny your God. See,
yeah.
If I could speak honestly, it don't feel good.
No.
No, it never does. It don't nope. Seem
good. Nope.
You don't call this love, but it's necessary pain.
Necessary pain.
Seeing breathing is for change. Even when life may be bittersweet, it's working.
It's working like. And now my pain is life.
Ooh,
and now I'm growing life. Background shake.
I'm singing. Ooh, la, la.
And now my heart is like.
Because
it was painful like.
Ooh, la, la.
Yeah.
La, 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 la.
Sing.
It don't feel good.
Nope.
But growing never does, it don't seem fair.
Anybody ever feel like that sometimes?
No.
You hold this love, necessary pain. It's the ingredient for change. Even when life may be bittersweet.
Everybody sing.
It don't feel good. But growing never does, it don't seem fair. This love, necessary pain, is the ingredient for change. Even when life may be bittersweet,
it's for me. All right. Just all right.
Yes.
Woo.
Ah, that was a good service.
Yeah, that was that honey child. Lee.
Oh, good.
Get a hat, John Junior. That's all right. You hang out. You hang
good.
That's all right.
We could be out here all day.
We need something to
Yo,
take
gang.
For the week.
For real.
Yeah, you only God.
We been whole lot.
So are you.
Hey, man, we love
that
you.
Ain't gonna be enough. Huh? I love y'all too.
All right, you hang in there, okay?
Hey, as long as you're around, I'm going to hang in.
All right.
Hang on, Lenny.
Can't turn around.
Can, no, no turn around. No, don't look back.
I'm already doing it.
All right. All right. Don't look back. We gonna look. We love you guys. Love you, Steph. Thanks for hanging out with us, Stephanie.
Good. I love you guys.
Grandma.
Good to see you.
Oh, Earl.
Yeah. Danielle, good to see you. I haven't seen you in a long time. You look good.
Yeah.
Really
good right now.
Yeah.
Come on, I love her.
Love you too, John.
Huh?
I love you too.
Are you still on there?
I'm still here.
All but, right.
Oh, praise the Lord.
Well, I'm hugging you now.
Y'all are too crazy.
Okay.
Oh.
All right, we're going to let you go, Danielle, because you got to call Sister Smith.
Jesus. I'm going to get a meal. Okay.
You send me her number.
Oh wait,
yes,
I
will.
It.
I'll text it.
Okay.
No, you know what? Call her on her landline. So right? You want to call her landline?
Yeah. I don't know which one that is. Which number?
Well, she uses her cell phone number for the service.
It's a 718 number.
Oh, okay. 523-4248.
That's it.
Yeah, that's her landline.
Okay, I'll call her on that.
The cell phone is the 917-945-3557.
Got you. Okay.
If you need that, I'll text it to you. I could do that.
I got it on the paper you sent. I got it.
Okay. I don't know what happened to Sister Davis. Again, sometimes she has technical difficulties with her phone anyway.
Got you.
Zoom or not. So,
Yeah, just.
But she is, she does hear the service.
Uh-huh.
So, and at that point, she said, that's all that counts. If I can hear the service,
right,
I'm good.
Exactly.
Okay.
All right, girl.
All right, girl. Thanks, girl. Woo!
See y'all. See y'all.
Long. Have a blessed week, everybody.
Yes.
You too. Love you guys.
Love you, girl. Love you, Steph.
All right. Bye, everybody.
All right. Take care.
Okay.